Hey, the folks, got a new knife for you. What I have here is the Rob Carter Cricut. If you follow Rob on Instagram, you might have seen his posts on this. I think he was posting this even before, yeah, definitely before Blade of this year, because I got to check him out at Blade Show this past June. And I was so, as soon as I saw it, I was like, wow, I got to have one of these. I got to admit, when I first saw it on Instagram, I was like, you know, it's a little tiny. I don't even know if I can use that, but when I got to handle it in Blade Show, I was like, wow, that's awesome. I told Rob right there, dude, I gotta have one of these. It is a smaller knife. I think the overall length is a little over 5 inches. The blade length is a little over 2.5, so it's a very tiny blade. I got a comparison knife for you. What's up? Here's my Spyderco Dragonfly 2, so it's about the same size as a Dragonfly 2. So if you guys have that, you'll get an idea how big the blade is. Although it's about the same size, the cutting edge on the Cricut is a little bit longer than Dragonfly 2. Just some specs on it. Rob did make this out of full titanium. So the lock side's titanium, the show side's titanium. I'm not 100% sure. I think, I don't know, Rob's out on this boat, but I just texted him. I could have sworn, well, actually, the bandit told me that Rob made this Damascus himself. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool, exotic, nice pattern on the Damascus, kind of like a raindrop. I would think that was a raindrop, but even though the swirls are a little bit different over here. Pretty cool. Good stock of steel. This side actually has the more beautiful patterns on it. So that's the Cricut. What amazes me is for such a small knife, now this is a frame lock, Rob's quality does not skip at all. It's the same quality as my other knives. The lockup is early. Lockup is solid. He prides himself on that. I like the relief cut he puts on here to disengage, because it is a small knife, but he had, you know, he designed it so that you can unlock it fairly easily. You can see that there's no stick. That's just amazing craftsmanship that he can make something this small. And it's just awesome, awesome. Titanium backspacer. Now, this doesn't have a pocket clip. I guess he could have if I harassed him enough. But what he does is he puts his titanium. The backspacer is basically sticks out to make this lanyard holder here thing. Of course, I attach my Scoopy Loops giant bead on it promptly. Which, again, like kind of like similar with Nick's knife, it kind of adds to the purchase of the knife. It actually works well without it, because the knife is actually pretty well designed so that the thumb wrap accommodates your thumb, and it's perfect. I mean, this is where the stop pin is, the internal stop pin. So I guess Rob milled out a hole on the blade and it travels on that. If you guys are familiar with those crescent shape lines inside the blade. And this, I mean, I know I'm showing you guys really close up. That is tiny. See if you guys can see it. I don't know if you guys can see the pin. You may be able to. Basically, it rides on that. Just amazing, amazing work by Rob, as always. The detent is spectacular. Hear that? That is a positive detent. Jeez. Which is one of the main things that you need to make an awesome flipper knife. Rob was telling me that he actually wished it flipped a little stronger. As soon as I got it, I'm like, what is he talking about? This thing flies out like crazy. It's amazing. Amazing. Good designer knife. Again, he's also making a bigger one. He makes these bigger. I think it's a 3.5-inch blade. If you follow Rob, you'll see that he made this awesome, awesome 3.5 Cricut for a gentleman on Instagram. I think it's Slustud. I don't know how you pronounce it, but it's awesome. It's got like copper inlays and copper bolster. It was just spectacular. Spectacular. I think I pretty much own every one of Rob's designs. He's going to have to make another one. I am bouncing around the idea of getting a larger Cricut because this is a pretty neat design. He took care of me and the Bennett. Me and the Bennett got this. This is a perfect little EDC knife. I mean, you can just throw it in your pocket. In my case, I just throw it in my breast pocket, and it's awesome. It just disappears. It's beautiful. It's just a beautiful knife. It's super sharp, too. This thing is very sharp. Yeah, just a small, quick video for you guys. We're probably not going to do another Wieners and Steel before New York Custom Knife Show. In fact, the next Wieners and Steel will probably be at New York Custom Knife Show. So we're looking forward to that. And if you guys are attending the show, please come up to us, say hello. You guys all know what the Bandit is. Look for two Asian guys, a guy with a beard, and a fine-looking Italian gentleman, and that would be the Fruch. But we're definitely excited about it. If you guys haven't attended the New York Custom Knife Show, it's definitely a little more personal than Blade Show, where it's a little bit overwhelming how much talent, how many knife makers are there. New York Custom Knife Show is one of the better shows to attend in the East Coast, in my personal opinion, as compared to East Coast Custom Knife Show. I think more of the heavy hitters like to attend New York Custom Knife Show. Burnley, Lambert, Voxnays, the Begg Brothers. We got, who else is coming? Jeremy Horton, who I forgot to check off on my Instagram, which was not intentional. Definitely want to check out some of his work. I mean, there's so many. Alan Elishewitz, everybody's going to be there. And I know I'm forgetting somebody, but everybody's going to be there. Everybody that is somebody is going to be there. So it's going to be pretty cool to go. And hopefully you get to hang out with you guys. Maybe you guys can hang out with us when we're filming Wieners and Steel. But it should be fun. All right, guys. Peace.